Obviously, we're all concerned with the future, and we're all, I suppose, nervous and embarrassed in a way at the amount of consumption and the lack of thought. And we're all guilty in a sense, and of course the building business is a major contributor, or perhaps the major contributor to global warming. So I think what people have and what they build is really, really important. But I think as architects, of course nowadays you think, before you do anything, you think about sustainability. I mean, the only reason that my work is really has sides to it of a spiritual nature are that I do sometimes build churches. And there, part of the brief is to make a place which people feel comfortable in, but comfortable in to pray or to be nearer to God. And so that you work hard to make an atmosphere which is spiritual. But I don't... I mean, I think it's very dangerous if you try and say that the shops that I do are spiritual, because clearly they're not. I mean, it's about a different thing. In a way that you use the same things to make a shop, in the sense that you use material, and you use light, and you use proportion and scale and all these things. But, and of course, I mean, I come from a Christian Protestant, a kind of Methodist background from Yorkshire. Well, I think if you're asked to design something for an exhibition or as an inspiration, obviously as an architect you quite like to do buildings. And it's quite nice to experiment with a building that you couldn't, you know, that has one single function in a sense. And I've always been drawn to very, very early, both Neolithic stone buildings, you know, in Scotland, which go back 5,000 years, but also more sophisticated ones there are in Ireland, which are very simple huts, really, built of stone, without using glue or mortar, so that the stones are built in an arch. And they have a single function. I mean, it's just an oratorium. It's a tiny church, but it's one material inside and out. It has one function, very simple, understandable shape. You know, we are living in a different kind of society, but you know, everyone says the same thing, that the increased you know, the increased standard of livings and the economy being richer since the war, really, I mean, hasn't made people happier. So, you know, but one tries to make things which at least excite people. And buildings that are, you know, comfortable to be in. I love the Design Week in Milan, obviously. I mean, it's a fantastic party. And in that sense, I mean, of course it sounds frivolous, but actually interaction with people is, I mean, it's all about people that make things, really. And it's ironic that I have to go from London to Milan, you know, to spend time with my friends.